Welcome to TMS Software TV. With the recent release of TMS WEB Core, debugging is now fully integrated into the RAD Studio IDE. Just a heads up, the existing functionality that was in previous versions is still available. You will still be able to debug in the browser if that is your preferred way of debugging. This is an added feature that allows you to debug inside the IDE as well. Just a heads up, right now, this technology is available for browsers that are related to Chrome. Today, this means Google Chrome and the new Microsoft Edge using Chromium technology are supported. To be precise, at the end of the video, I'll show you the options that you have where to debug your application. It's a new setting in the options dialog. Let's look at this example application. I start the application from the IDE, and it shows the current weather. The key part of this application is the web service interaction. It uses a web service that is publicly available to everybody. However, the result of the web service has to be processed and then shown in the user interface that you see right here. During development, this has been tricky, to say the least, especially if you get started with TMS WEB Core, because you need to parse the JSON object that comes back and you might want to check what comes back from the web service. So this is how you can do it now with the new debugging feature right from inside the IDE. Without going into much detail of the source code, I go into my service manager, and here I have the call to the web service using await. So I know when this line is executed, afterwards I can check the response, signified by L response right here. And then I can check if the return status is 200, which indicates an okay response from the web service. Everything's in order and I can process the results. But before that, I want to inspect what is actually inside of L result. So I can set a breakpoint right here inside of the IDE, and I start with debugging and the web application launches as before. However, we immediately go into the breakpoint because when the application starts up, it'll trigger the web service request as the weather changed. So here, now you can see that the L response object is null, and my this, which is JavaScript for the current object that we're located in, the current context, contains all the properties of the class that I'm in. And right now I'm in tweather service manager. So looking at the class name, expanding it a bit so you can see tweather service manager. So all this information is updated for the current position that I'm in. This is a data module, so the name of the data module is weather service manager. Everything represents the current state of my class. I can see all the field variables right here. I can see the properties. Everything is reflected at this current point in the application. The breakpoint is set inside of the Delphi IDE, and I can have my local variables. I can also add watches. I can add a watch for the L response, and I can enable that right now. It's null, of course. And with F8, or using the menu, whichever you prefer, I can step ahead one step. And now L response has changed because the response from the web service has been received. This is how easy you can now analyze responses from asynchronous processes, because the await makes it possible to go to the next step easily, and then you can look at your L response, what the data actually is. And looking into the class right here, I see that the response contains my 200, but let's go even farther. Is there a status? Right here. So L response status, I know that that is now 200, that the status text is okay. I also get the response URL with the openweathermap.org. I get the response type. Everything is immediately visible inside of the IDE without going into the browser, going into the developer console right there. And best of all, and this is really a nice feature to have, you can dig into the response in a tree structure. Like, you can dig into the response. So here is the city that I requested the weather for. It is Estero. I'm located in Estero right now. And here are the coordinates that have been used, the country, the whole object can be browsed inside of the IDE. There's no need. I've seen myself while writing this application, this feature hasn't been available. So I've literally been writing lines like console, log, L response, and so on to have the information on the console. Because you might say you have the network tab inside of your browser to see the flow of the network packages. Well, that's very nice to have what kind of packages have been sent from the web server or the packages that you sent to the web server. However, that doesn't tell you when that is. So the ability to have a breakpoint inside of the IDE and then to evaluate your next step is really, really good to have. And this feature is now available in the new version of TMS Web Core. You can also dig into the list and see all the different array objects and all the different properties for the different classes that are being returned. So this is really a very, very concise web service with a lot of information that is given to you. I won't go into the source code. However, this is the feature you've been looking for. With regards to the features, the local variables are supported, the watch list is supported, and that means all the debug functionality in the run menu, like inspect, evaluate, modify, all that is available. As I've only shown the watch list and the local variables, let me show one more, the evaluate modify dialog. You can type lresponse.status. And this is a read-only property, so I can't set a new value, but if it were something where you could set a new value, you would use this dialog to assign a new value to your variable, for example. You can also easily add a watch using this dialog. So everything that you have available with the debugger from your VCL applications or FireMonkey applications, this is now available for TMS Web Core as well. Finally, hint windows are also supported. So if you hover over certain keywords, you get the evaluated response inside of the hint window as well. These are all very complex object structures, so the hint window is not what I would use in this case. Last but not least, I would like to show you how you enable this, if this is not enabled by default in your installation for whatever reason, or if you prefer the previous functionality inside of the web browser. You simply can go to the Tools, Options menu, then select TMS Web Options. And then there's a new entry added to the recent versions, which is called Enable Debugging inside of the IDE. And right now it's set to true because it is enabled. For more examples on how to debug with TMS Web Core and all other topics with this great web framework, go to web.tmssoftware.com to learn more about especially how to download a trial version. If you haven't looked at it in your Delphi version yet, this is the link to go to download the application. And as always, if you have suggestions for more videos that you would like to see on this channel, first of all, subscribe that you don't miss any of the new videos that we release, and then just comment on the video. Your feedback is appreciated and will definitely be considered for future videos. Thank you for listening. Stay safe. Take care.